Hi students, so today our topic is on acceleration. So far we saw about distance, displacement, speed, velocity, and the next quantity is your acceleration. Imagine you are going to travel in a bumpy road or a road which is crowded heavily, it's full of traffic jam. So in that case we often put our brake, so which means there is a change in its velocity. Velocity is not being common unless and until you are able to travel in a road where you have a smooth travel. In that case I claim my velocity is uniform, but over here we feel the road is so crowded and there is a quiet traffic jam, or if you are just traveling around a hilly side you will feel that is a change in its velocity. So whenever a change in velocity takes place with a specified time, we call that quantity as acceleration. So acceleration is defined as the rate of change in velocity, the change in velocity in a given time. So this change, I use a word delta over here. So this symbol, this triangular symbol delta, means a change in its velocity. So now just plainly go for the definition. As per the definition, you'll see how the notations are working. Acceleration is change in velocity by time taken. Now what is your velocity formula? Velocity is equal to displacement by time taken. So just split this, the above quantity, velocity, into 1 by time. Now substitute for velocity. What is velocity? Displacement by time. Therefore displacement by time into this 1 by time. This 1 by time is coming as such. So now just multiply, you will get displacement by t square. So acceleration can also be written as displacement by time square, or it is just change in velocity by time. This is a plain one and you have to apply it and you'll get the other one. Now based on this we can write our SI unit. Our SI unit will be meter by second square, and CGS unit is centimeter by second square. So if at all in a numerical they didn't give anything, they're just specifying a car is going with moving with 56 meter per second, and it is also having in another notations or units like 0.2 meter per second square. So in that case you don't confuse yourself. Whenever the word meter per second, whenever you see the unit meter per second, it is associated with your velocity or the speed of the car. So if you are going to have meter by second square, it is just your acceleration. So by seeing your unit we can specify the quantity which we are learning on. Now the next condition. So consider initially I'm going to travel in a speed of 50 km per hour, and after some 10 minutes I'm going to increase my velocity, say 60 km per hour, and after some 30 minutes I'm going to decrease my speed, just like 50 km per hour. So in all these cases, yes, acceleration takes place, but at one point it is increasing and the other point it is decreasing. So I cannot keep on call them acceleration, but instead when the velocity is increasing with respect to time, I define it as acceleration. So if it is going to decrease with time, then I can call retardation or negative acceleration. Okay, if I'm going to decrease with respect to time, it is called as your negative of acceleration or just retardation. Now listen, from A to B I'm going to travel with a speed of 50 km, and from B to C, okay, I'm going to increase my speed, let it be around 60. Here my car is accelerating, okay, the speed is increasing, therefore it shows a acceleration, that is the positive acceleration. Now I'll give one more example. From C to D I'm going in 60, and from D to E I'm going to reduce it. Let me make 40 km per hour. Here my acceleration is taking place, but the value of acceleration is in negative. See, it's going to decrease. Okay, so whenever your acceleration decreases, you call it to be as your retardation. So using that, we will just use our formulas to evaluate it. So acceleration is defined as change in velocity by time taken. So at a point A, the car is moving with the initial velocity, because the velocities keep on changing. I cannot use the same notation every time. So I'm going to use a different notation over here. So therefore, at this point, the initial velocity, let the notation used for initial velocity is U. And after traveling for a distance to B, Okay, the velocity is changing within that particular time. So I'll use this as your final velocity, and the notation for final velocity is v. So now it is changing. Now the formula is change in velocity by time taken. Therefore, a is equal to final minus initial divided by t. So v and u are velocities only, but the thing is, one is your final velocity and the other one is your initial velocity. So you just cross multiply this. At is equal to v minus u, or at plus u is equal to v. So you can obtain an equation like this also, but this is your standard equation. Okay, this is your standard equation. Make a note of this equation. Later in your lessons, you will learn this as your equations of motion. This equation will be learned in your equations of motion. Okay, so maybe in your next section you'll be learning this probably. So just make a note of this one. So you can write acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time, v minus u by t. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to give some value for my v, u and t, and I'll just see whether it is possible to obtain a positive acceleration and negative acceleration, and probably we'll arrive at, because it's just a simple math over here. Now the condition is, if v is greater than u, just take an example, v is 5, u is 3, t is 1, and substitute in your acceleration equation, v minus u by t, 5 minus 3 by 1, which is 2. Now the quantity is positive. The case is, if v is less than u, if v is less than u, v is 5, u is 10. Again, I'm going to take the time is around 1 second or 1 hour, whatever it is. Apply in your formula. A is equal to, what is your formula here? A is equal to v minus u by t. 5 minus 10 by 1. Therefore, it is a negative quantity. So based on this condition, I can get a positive acceleration as well as a retardation. Now, always remember, your acceleration cannot tell about your direction. The direction in which an object moves is never told by your acceleration, because acceleration itself arises because of the change in velocity. So a velocity can change in its magnitude, can change in its direction, and change in its both magnitude and direction. So whenever a velocity changes with respect to its direction, therefore it is because it gives you the quantity acceleration. If the change is going to be increasing, suppose if my velocity is increasing, therefore it will give me a positive quantity. If my velocity is going to decrease, a negative quantity of acceleration. So always remember, your acceleration is not going to give you the direction, whereas the velocity is the one which gives the direction. Because if my velocity is going to change, instead of moving in a right side, if I'm going to take a turn and go to the other way around, so which means my velocity is going to change. So that is a decrease in velocity. My velocity will be changing. So velocity gives the direction, not your acceleration. Acceleration just states what will happen to it. Okay. Okay. The next topic is on classifications of your acceleration. You will learn about uniform acceleration and variable acceleration. So it's just same that uniform, equal changes in velocity in equal interval of time. So for equal changes, for every 1 hour, the change in velocity is going to be the same. Okay, velocity is changing, but the amount or the magnitude in which it's going to change is going to be the same. So after 1 hour, 20 kilometers. After another 1 hour, it's going to be 20 kilometer. So if that change is going to be constant, then it is called as your uniform acceleration. So you're just moving under a gravity. Okay, if you're going to fall down, then you experience your gravitational force. In that case, you'll call it as your uniform acceleration. But if at all I'm not going to undergo a motion in acceleration due to gravity, in that case I'll call as your variable acceleration. Unequal changes in velocity in equal interval of time is called as my variable acceleration. Okay, so hope you'll get the difference between uniform and variable, because these terms you have been studying again and again, right from your speed and velocity. So when the word uniform comes, it means just equal. Okay, so equal both in your numerator as well as in your denominator quantities. Equal changes in velocity by equal interval of time, and variable comes. Okay, if variable comes, it is unequal changes in equal interval of time. And for your variable acceleration, as we all discussed above, if you're moving in a car in a heavy traffic or in a hilly road, if you're going to travel, all these of your variable acceleration. So right from your childhood, you have been heard. You have been used to this word, which is called as your gravity. Okay, So remember, you will be learning in your physics, one is your small g and another one is your capital G. So capital G is somewhere attached to a different concept, okay? So let us focus on the notation of small g, okay? Because your capital G is along your natures of forces, okay? It is called as your universal gravity. Okay, that is your universal gravity. So we use a notation capital G for that. Whereas the gravitational force which we are going to experience within the earth is denoted by the word small g. So you cannot use the words which you want as such. You have to stick on to the proper notation. So now, acceleration due to gravity. So what does it mean by? Whenever you drop a body from a building or something, we know the earth tends to attract everything towards itself. It just try to pull it towards the center or downwards. So once it falls down, there is a change in its velocity. The velocity keeps on changing at each and every point, and the change in velocity in a given time is nothing but your acceleration, and this acceleration is going to be uniform. Okay, this acceleration is going to be uniform, and this is called as your acceleration due to gravity. So it is also termed by another name, which is called as free fall. You just let an object down from a certain height, the object tends to fall smoothly without any interpretation, unless and until you have a frictional force because of your air resistance. Okay, if you drop a paper, the paper might float for some time, but anyhow it will come and settle down. If you drop a stone, it does not have any disturbance, it will just directly fall down. So it is called as your acceleration due to gravity. So let us assume, I'm just going to drop a stone from a top of a building, just dropping it down. So which means it is also going towards the earth. In that case, I am going along with the earth's force. That is, I'm just helping along with the earth. In that case, I'll take my G as a positive quantity. But instead, I'm going to do something against the earth. I'm going to throw a stone above. So in that case, I'm just making the stone to move away from the gravitational attraction of your earth. So your G value will be negative because I'm just trying to pull it off. Okay. So in that case, your G is negative. So when it falls down, you will find the velocity increases. But when you are throwing up, the velocity, once it reaches the peak, it will decrease. So we have an example for this. Just look at it. So you're just standing on the top of a building. I'm just going to drop it. At t is equal to 1 second, this is my velocity. Okay, this is my velocity, which is changing at each point. At t is equal to 1 second, my velocity, let me take it as 9.8, and after 1 second, that is t is equal to 2, this 19.6, you can see it's just a multiple. Okay, you note it down, it's a multiple of your 9.8. and t is equal to 3, it is becoming 29.4, and t is equal to 4, 39.2. So I told you, when you are going to do a work, or if I'm just going to drop it down, I'm just making my g value as positive. Okay, I'm just going along the force, which means my velocity increases. So moment when it comes and reaches the ground, it will have a huge velocity. Okay, so all these are your multiples, which shows and clearly indicates it is moving in a uniform acceleration. So whenever you drop a ball down, okay, whenever you drop an object down, your G value increases. You are doing with respect to your G, therefore velocity increases. Now the other way, I'm just going to throw an object. If I want to throw an object above, vertically upwards, okay, instead of using the word throw, here onwards we'll stick on to the word, we'll be using the word vertically upwards. But all I'm going to make an object move vertically upwards, I have to apply a force, okay, I have to give a velocity. So in this case, so initially I'm going to give a velocity of 39.2, so it will move some more distance. At that time, let the time be 2 seconds, it is becoming 29.4. In 3 seconds, it is 19.6. In 4 seconds, it is 9.8. At t is equal to 5, the velocity will tend to become 0. There will be no velocity. Since it does not have anything, now who will capture it? Your acceleration due to gravity will make the stone to fall down. So, and that is the next part. Don't get to mix up into that. So, let us see this alone. So, initially, you will give a velocity and it will reach to the maximum height it can, and that is your final velocity. And you will see that is a change in its velocity. So it is decreasing. So in this case, the velocity decreases. Why? Because we are going against our gravity. So this is what you term mean by acceleration due to gravity. If you are going to drop an object down, you are doing along with your gravity, which means increase in velocity. If I'm going to make an object move vertically up, I'm going to apply velocity, and once it reaches the maximum point, it will become zero. In this case, my gravity, I'm just doing against a work, I'm doing something against my gravity, so my gravitational force will be negative. So you all know what is the constant of gravity, which is 9.8 meter s minus 2, because it is acceleration due to gravity. So not everywhere along the earth you will have the same value, at some parts it will decrease and some parts you will have the same value of your 9.8 meter s minus 2. So s minus 2 means it is an acceleration due to gravity. The earth's acceleration, every planet, maybe a massive planet, will has its own atmosphere, which means it will has its own acceleration. Imagine Jupiter, which is much more massive, it also has its own atmosphere and everything. Okay, so students, try to recall all these topics. Tomorrow we'll be solving the numericals. Try to recall between distance and displacement. Before that, you have to recall what is scalar and vector, and after that, distance and displacement, speed and velocity, acceleration, uniform acceleration, variable acceleration, and acceleration due to gravity. This acceleration due to gravity is really important. It will has its effect in each and everything. In your upcoming lessons, whatever you learn, you will have your gravitational force involving in it. So have a clear thought of all these. Get ready. And in the next video will be on your numericals. Thank you.